Welcome back. In this new tutorial, we have to check the new domain controller configuration. Okay, so remember, we need to compare between DC1 and DC2. Those two domain controllers have to have the same database, okay? Because we copy the database from DC1 to DC2. Also, we need to check all the configuration settings for the DNS. So let's go and check it out. First, we need to log on into the domain by pressing Ctrl+Alt+Delete. Remember, we are not going into this local computer. We have to switch user, other users, and log on into the domain. Let me put the username, password, press enter. Great. Now, as you can see, this is gonna be the DC2. First, let me see what is going on here. Okay, collecting the information, and we have the two roles, the Active Directory Domain Services and the DNS. Let me close this server manager. Go back to start, click on DNS. As you can see, we have the DNS number 2. We open it up and we gotta look for the forward lookup zones. And you can see that we have the pctextreme.local domain. This is the first zone that this domain controller has. Now, if we need to compare the primary domain controller with the second domain controller, all we have to do is to take a look at this number. Right in here, we have 136. That means all the activities in this domain controller. You know, whatever is new, whatever is changed, right? So we need to compare, right? We are going to open the DC1. We can do it from here and see if we got the same number. Let me type the domain controller name, which is gonna be let me put it in capital letters so it's gonna look much better. DC1. Great. Now you can see that we have the two domain controllers. So from DC2, we look at this number. Let's go back to DC1. We open the forward lookup zone, the zone, and you can see that we have the same number. Okay, next, we gotta go and check the Active Directory users and computer and see, you know, how many computers we got or how many usernames we got. Okay, let me minimize this DNS because we already know that we have the same records in DC2 and DC1. When I say records, I mean this. These are all records, okay? So let me minimize this. Go to Administrators Tools, Active Directory Users and Computers. And this is the domain name. We open it up and see, first of all, let's see how many computers we got. As you can see, we got the client number 1, how many domain controllers, we got DC1 and DC2. Okay, let me go back to computers and I'm going to show you how replication is gonna take place, okay? Let me create a new computer. For the name, we are going to put test. Okay, we click OK, and you can see that we have a new computer. Now, let me connect to the domain controller number 1, okay? Just remember, we are in DC2, okay? As you can see it right in here. We are going to connect to DC1. And We cannot change domain because we only have one domain, this one. Let me cancel this up, right click, and change domain controller. From this list, we need to select this one and click OK. Great. Let me open the domain, open computers, and you can see that the replication, it is working. So let me create a username. We're gonna create an user and we are gonna call it test. The last name is gonna be L. Test L. Okay, this is gonna be all together. Remember that this is the user logon name. This is the name that this user is gonna input into the operating system to log on into the domain. So let me click on next. This is capital letter. We need to set up a password. Let me do it right now. You got like a few options that you can choose from here. You know, if you want the user change the password at next logon, you can choose this option, or you can use this, you know, user cannot change password, or maybe password never expires or account is disabled. We are gonna leave it as default for now. We click on next. Then we click on finish. Great. Now you can see that we have a new user in this domain controller number one. So let me switch domain controller. We need to change domain controller. We're gonna go to DC. Hold on, let me see. We are, let me cancel this up. We are in DC one. Then we need to go to DC2. Just right in here. Sometimes you get like a little bit confused. So that's why, guys, you need to be careful, okay? So let me click OK. And now we are in DC1. Check the computers. And in this container, we have, you know, the new computer and the new user. Okay. So what we need to do next is to create OUs. Why do you need OUs? OUs are gonna let you divide or are gonna let you delegate administration in your domain. So let's see how can we do this. We click over to over the domain. We right click, go to organizational unit. For this one, we are gonna name it USA, right? Then we click OK, and you can see that we have a new OU. Now, let's go for the next one. We click on new organizational unit, and this one is gonna be called India, right? Just wanna say hi to all the people from India and thank you so much for giving me such a nice comment in my tutorials. Okay guys, let's go and keep going. We click OK. Next, we are gonna go and click over to new and select organizational unit. We click and we select Colombia. Okay, so these are three different countries, okay? We click right in here, and you can see that we have 1, 2, and 3 new OUs. Next, we need to create sub-OUs. Sub-OUs are gonna be inside of the parent OUs. So let's go over here. We click on new OU, then this is gonna be the computers. Let me put it right here. Computers. You have the option to protect this oil, just in case, you know, you delegate administration and somebody else is gonna try to delete this oil. So with this option, this organization or unit is gonna be protected. So let's keep it like that. We click OK. Now you can see that inside of OU, we have computers. Now let's go for the next one. We click on here. This is gonna be for users, right? We click OK. We go back to the parent OU, and we have the two containers, right? Or the two organizational units. Let's go and do the same for India. Go right here. We go for computers. We click OK. Let's go and create another one. This is gonna be for users. Click OK. Next, we need to go to Colombia, do the same thing. New OU. It's gonna be computers. Click OK. And finally, we create the last one. It's gonna be for users. We click OK. Then, let's see what is going on here. Okay, what is going on, guys? that's a little bit funny thing that I do sometimes. Okay, so let's go and click on USA. So you can see that we have the OUs. India, we got the same thing, and Colombia, we got the same thing. Next, we need to create computers and users for each and every single OU. Okay? But we are gonna be doing this from DC number one. As you can see, we are in the number two. So this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to switch computer and we are gonna start working in DC number one. So let's go. Great. So as you can see, we are back in this domain controller number one. We need to open the Active Directory users and computers right in here. As you can see, you know, it is the same thing because, you know, we were working in DC2, but everything was replicated to DC1. Okay, so you can see the Colombian OU, the Indian OU, and the USA OU. Let me open this up and create, let me see, computers and users. We are gonna be doing this for each and every single OU, right? The same thing for India and the same thing for USA. So let me begin with the Colombian OU. We click on computers, new computer, and the computer name is gonna be C for Colombia, C for computer, and the number one. This is gonna be the computer number, okay? So in this field, you got the options to select a different user or group to join this computer to a domain, okay? So you can click on change and you can locate, you know, the domain and then the OU. And if you have different username and OUs that you want to delegate administration, you can select it from here, okay? But we are gonna get into that later. Let me cancel this up and click OK. As you can see, we have the new computer. Let's go and create a new user. We're doing it here, new user. For the name, we're gonna have C for Colombia, dash U for user, that's and the number one. Okay, you know what, let me make this easier. I'm gonna cut this up. I'm going to put this for last name, and you can see that C for Colombia, U for user, and the number one. So we can copy this full name and paste it right in here. And this is gonna be the LAGA name for this user. We click on next, and we set up a password, right? So let me set it up. Then we confirm the password. And you already know these options. Let's go and click on next and finish. Now you can see that we have computer number one and user number one. Okay guys, this is pretty much all for this tutorial, but in the next video, we need to create computers and users for India and USA. Don't miss the next tutorial because it is gonna be really nice. We need to delegate administration in this domain, right? So I will see you soon.